break the grip, his approach, grabbing my legs. I cannot let the person on top control my legs, or he's gonna easy looking for his pass. Right, so I gotta break that. Cross grip, the other one, fingers together, I will scoop behind the hand, right? I wanna create this, look, right? At the same time, I will pull and hang my body to increase my power here, to bring his arm down. I will do a short kick with my leg. Again, I will not exaggerate like that. It's just a short kick to break the grip. So look, short. I bring my elbows to my body and I hang to keep myself strong and keep breaking his posture down. From here, I can step on the hip, start to be more on my side, look for a classic guard, control heels, tripod, right? But what we work on that way is looking straight for the De La Riva. If I look for the De La Riva control and his legs are parallel here, my hook will be never too strong to control his legs if I'm in that angle. We also know, for the first fundamental we learn here, I will not step on the ground to move my body, because if I'm doing that, he's already passing here. He's gonna pass too easy. So what I'm gonna do is, again, between knees and hips, any area I post my foot is good, and this will help on my mobility from the body. I have this, I wanna move to the leg, I wanna hook to have a better angle. First thing I will do, I will turn my toes to the opposite side of the leg, look, and move my hips. I have the support from this connection and the other connection here on his body. He is my floor now. I will not step on the ground, I will step on my opponent. Now, to have a better angle to hook, I will use my support here to move my shoulders, look. So now, I start to get what? Going around of the leg, I want to work. So I start to have a better angle to attack. If I need to do one more, I keep going. Hip, shoulder. Hip, shoulder, as much as I need, until I find myself in a compo position. In a compo position, I feel I'm strong to attack. So now, my hook is strong. If I come back, my hook's not working much. I try to work on that hook, I will fail on that. That is an opportunity now to the person on top, pay back and pass your guard. So I break that. If I look for this one, it's fine. If I look for the De La Riva, look, I just hang, look. One, two, I'm here. Now I'm in the good angle. I still using the leg to block that step. Because if I do not block in the leg, he will just step and I gotta move again. So that's why I keep shielding here. Right, he tried to step. I keep working here, I keep moving. My mobility is all here, work on his body. I can switch grips, I can look for inside De La Riva, outside De La Riva, baby bolo to the side. I can switch in my grips. That's one option of grip, 2-on-1, but you can work. Cross collar and arm, we can work. Cross arm, heels, right? Cross arm, or just palm down, four fingers controlling the pants here. Find the grip, it's comfortable for you to work, right? And also, depends what you want. Some position, you're gonna like, if I look for a triangle, maybe the cross collar could be a better option, because I can handle him and bring his posture down, right? So if I look at a triangle, makes sense, I control it here, right, the lapel. But if I not look for a triangle, for example, if I look for the position we're gonna do today, this grip is fine. So what I wanna do now is disarm him to attack. So first thing I'm gonna do, when I start to sit up to attack him, I will kick in that leg, right? And I will do at the same time I kick the leg, I will sit up. That's my first position here. I know when I do that kick, that's no timing for him to pay back. If I just sit up like that, he can set up many things. But if I do this at the same time, I disarm his base, his balance, look. That's nothing he can do at that moment. So now I have my transition. Look how my legs gonna work. Both heels to the same side. I will drive this with me. And these hands will find the other one behind the leg, look. That's my strong position now. So adjust your body is always important. There's another kind of position you're looking for. It's jiu-jitsu, he's gonna move with you. So if you need to do some little adjustment, you will do. So I need some adjustment. My hands come to the ground now. My fingers point to my back, not to my opponent. If I work like that, many times you're gonna feel like you're not gonna have strength in your arms, you're gonna collapse down. So I wanna tie this, right? When I do this sit up, again, gonna have a better position, right? You're gonna feel yourself more comfortable. And this for the concept will work for a butterfly dive. I'm working hooks here, butterfly. If my hips, think about my shoulder line. Go forward here to the shoulder line. I start to do a lot of sweat on my belly to keep myself. If I bring this behind the line, I'm more comfortable, right? And this concept comes also to this position here, look. If my hips forward, my shoulders are backward like that, I'm already putting myself back on the ground. You don't need to help with that. I put myself on that spot. So look, hands, slide your head. My head comes tight on the leg. I'm always worried about choke, but now we are controlling the same side arm. What makes him have a hard time to choke? If you are working the other arm, you can have some loop choke for you, right? Or some choke. But as soon as I start to control the arm, I don't give him the option, right? So it's also a good way to control when you come across. Pay attention to my leg position. It's the same when you are ready to do the technical setup. We work on one. Same position. The legs come down. You can easily move over, right, to pass. But I'm here. I'm tight. Who's going to lock the leg? It's not the outside. It's the inside leg. Right? I'm ready. And now again, that's the leg I'm working with. I will work with angles around the leg. If I feel the knee come towards my chest heavy to put me down, it's gonna be hard to fight against his body weight, his energy, the gravity, and try to fight him back here. So I look for the smart way to work is what? Go around, he drive the knee, I go around. So all this energy he put on my chest, I will not fight back. I will just redirect away from my chest. That makes sense? And that shoulder, we're gonna a little pinch and help by kind of pushing this knee away. So every time I'm doing that, he will probably work with the second step he's doing here to try to keep the balance. And then is my moment to stand up or to simple go more deep around, right? Put the knee, I feel the pressure. Look, I walk around. I redirect that. When he starts to adjust his step, it's a good moment to stand up. I can go to single, I can go hit the other leg, right? And many times if you do this on the right moment with timing, you will not need to stand up with him. Put the pressure, I go here, look. I go deep here. You see how I go deep? How I drag here. I drag the leg, look. I have a good moment here to put him down. So I don't even need to be standing to do that, okay? So we're gonna make partners, we're gonna build this first.